The night I went horse riding, I headed back to my favourite restaurant in Essaouira, the Fish Bar. I ordered a burger with onion rings to take away. It was pretty busy, so I sat inside to wait, and they offered me a sample of their sardine and mozzarella balls. They were delicious.
Hi guys, it's the day after horse riding and I'm going out. Today's my day for shopping, so I'm just going to browse the shops, see if there's anything I want to buy within my budget. And yeah, I'm actually doing better than I thought I was. I'm walking fine. I thought I'd be a bit like John Wayne today, but I'm doing better than I expected, actually, much better. I think it was all of the steps that I've been through so far, like Lyon and my friends in Spain. The only thing that I do have is a slight blister on my finger from holding the reins, but otherwise really good. So let's go and take a look around.
With its cobbled streets and noisy seagulls, Essaouira really reminds me of Port Haven in Ghibli's adaptation of Howl's Moving Castle. I wonder which of these shops leads to Calcifer. I watch a lot of Japanese YouTubers and love the look of the food there. On this trip, I've been lucky enough to try mochi balls in Lyon and onigiri on the train to Narbonne. I also found someone making takoyaki down the back streets of Essaouira. I wanted to try the original squid balls, but they didn't have any, so I decided to wait. But then, every time I went back, the shop was closed, so I never got to try any. Word to the wise, never wait. Eat whatever's on offer. This place fascinates me. It's a traditional herbalist down a remote back street. It looks like something out of a fairy tale. What a wonderful place to work. At one point, I accidentally left the Medina. Then, I found myself in the fish market. This place is heaven for seagulls and cats. This little alley was crazy. I had to duck down to pass through it. I stopped for falafel in a cafe and made a friend. Sadly, I didn't order anything he wanted to eat.
Okay, so I've had a really lovely day. I've looked around all of the shops, all of them, but there's not a lot I really want to buy. I was looking for a little charm for my charm bracelet. So my mum bought a charm bracelet when I was born and we've been adding to it over the years. So because of the horse riding yesterday, I was looking for a tiny, tiny silver horse to put on the charm bracelet. But I've been everywhere and there are camels, there are plenty of Hand of Fatima, there are shoes, there are fish, there was even a kangaroo. I can't find a horse. So I think I have to make do with the beach sand. So I'm just going to wander around. I'm going to find something sweet. I've just had falafels at a nice little cafe. And now I'm going to try and find something sweet to take back to my hotel room and go and relax for a bit because my legs are feeling the exercise at the moment. have you been making these?
Maybe more than 34 years.
34?
Just making instrument, but wood before. 10 years before, like 44 years now.
Okay.
When I was a child, yeah, 7.
Did your family make these?
Yeah, uncles. Yeah.
Uncles. So it's like almost a drum.
Yeah,
and
drums
a...
and yes, huh. Yes, it's two instruments in one. Yeah, drum.
Okay. And is this mother of pearl?
Yes.
Okay.
This is mother of pearl. Wow. Yes. Yeah.
And the black.
The black one is the ebony and the lemon tree.
Lemon tree
lemon,
and ebony.
Yes.
And the main part is.
This is the mahogany.
Okay.
Mahogany.
Wow.
Yes.
That is an expensive instrument. It's a beautiful instrument.
The skin is from is the camel neck.
Okay.
Strings, the goat guts, camel and the goat.
It's amazing.
Yeah. Handmade. No machine.
I finally found something sweet, but also extremely hot.
This is absolutely delightful. Nutella and almonds. Mm.
Laughing cow. This has got to be a doorway to a secret society. It's actually Tifana, the Berber script.
Hi guys, so I failed. I failed to keep my money in my wallet. And you will fail too. The minute that you enter a medina, you need to understand that you are going to part with all of your money before you leave. So I thought I was home dry. I was on the last street back to my accommodation, and I happened to see a lovely little side shop with trousers. I've had my eye on Moroccan trousers since I got here because they look really comfortable. They sort of tie up at the back and the front. They look really nice and cool. I thought I could wear them here. I could wear them, sorry, my hair is an absolute mess. I've been out in the wind and the sun and the waves and everything. But yeah, I thought that I could wear them here, I could wear them in Rwanda. But all of the shops were super busy and I kind of felt a bit self-conscious going in and trying on trousers and asking how to put them on when there were so many people about. But down this back street, there was a little shop selling these, and I went in and the woman was so nice and so lovely. And I ended up buying two pairs, black and red. But just as I turned around to come home, I glanced in the jewellery shop next door and I saw the perfect, perfect little Moroccan horse. And I had been searching for this all day. I've been around about 20 jewellery shops. About two or three of those 20 had a horse of some kind, but it wasn't very nicely made. It was sort of one side was imprinted and the back was just, you know, concave. It wasn't that good. It wasn't that nice. This is perfect. It's exactly what I wanted to remember my time here and the horses. So yeah, I'm really pleased.